Okay, welcome everybody to the stream. We're going to be finally doing a mode that I've not had chance to get around to doing until now, which is the Infinity mode. This is the secondary mode in the game that's supposed to be like kind of its own thing in a sense. I did play the challenge mode that one time after I did the DLC stages, and they were kind of meh. I suppose, like they were there, they were just the kind of there, I feel, really. But yeah, let's jump into infinite mode, or infinity mode, I should say.
ある日突然、異界の一角に周囲を威圧するかのように立ち並ぶ大きな塔の群れが出現した。王道十二級にちなんだ十二の塔、それらを作り出したのはオリンポスの主神ゼウスであった。
彼らの塔を取り出そうと、
ゼウスの娘アテナと息子アレスは塔へと急ぐのだった。
父上、この塔は一体何なのでしょう。
おお、来たか。お前たち、この塔は多くの戦場が階層を成した十二塔だ。壮観であろう。
十二塔。
うん。そしてすべての塔を攻略し、わしのもとにたどり着いた者にはなんとオリンポスの主神の座が贈られるのだ。
父上、今何と言われたのでしょうか。
主神の地位を譲ると言ったのだ。お前たち二人もうかうかしている暇はないぞ。わしは最後の塔の頂上で待っているからな。
お待ちください、父上。行ってしまわれた。
冗談ではない。父上の思いつきでオリンポスの主神が変わるなど許されることではないぞ。
だが父上はやると言ったなら必ず実行されるはず。私たちが塔を攻略しなければ他の者が主神に。
アテナ殿、アレス殿、お二人もゼウス殿の話を聞いたようですね。
あなたたちは。
すでに味方の中には主神になるのも悪くないと野心を匂わせている方々がいると。
なんてことだ。
アテナさんとアレスさんは塔の攻略に挑むのでしょう。私たちに手伝わせてください。
That's funny。
なぜだ。まさか我らを利用して主神の座を得ようとしているのではあるまいな。
違います。私が元
に来たのは
王侯貴族の争いが国同士の戦に
I always forget about Joan of Arc。
民も戦火に巻き込まれました。
Then again, I don't really play the Bladestorm series. It's not my cup of tea.
Unfortunately.
If it played like a Warriors game, just with a Hundred Years War flavor, then sure. I just don't like the strategic elements to it. It's so off-putting.
同じオリンポスの神であるアレス殿かアテナ殿に急ぎ主神の座を継いでもらうのが良策であろう。
せや、うちはこの異界でダッキちゃん以外にも友達ができたんや。友達同士が喧嘩しそうなら止めなあかん。
なるほどな。わかった。そういうことなら力を借りるぞ。
ええ、皆さん、よろしくお願いします。共にこの塔へと挑みましょう。
So, select seven initial party members for the Infinity mode. In Infinity mode, your allies from story mode do not carry over. Okay, so we're starting from scratch. You must work to befriend characters once again. That is lame. So I can't just take level 100 Nazer and just wreck everything. I guess they did think ahead. There's always a chance that an officer will join you when you defeat them, right? The further into Infinity Mode the battle is, the higher the probability that they will join you. Okay. So it's like a recruitment thing. Are you sure I just can't use Nazer? Aha! No, screw you, game, I can. I thought it said that I couldn't, though. Unless it's only limited to certain characters. Yeah, it's letting me use what I already had before. Slipnir is the fastest, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Red Hair is no longer the fastest anymore. Rip. There was a time where it was. Oh, so you can pick people who do treasure chests and stuff. I guess the higher the level, the more probability they have. I wish I could kind of sort people by level. I'll put Zhaoyu there. It's basically got to be people that have leveled up quite a bit. So many characters off level 1 that I've like barely even leveled up much. If at all, I should say. Sun Changsheng. Begin with these members, yes, since the game lets me. Even though it said that I had to work for everything. Anyway, the objective of Infinity Mode is to complete each of Zeus's trials and eventually defeat him in battle. Trials consist of various stages and rules that become more difficult as you progress, build up your skills, take on the final challenge. In some cases, claiming a swift victory may allow you to skip over a level. Try to clear stages as quickly as possible to reach the levels with better rewards. Camps all carry over by the looks of it too, so... might as well throw these upgrades on that are here while I can, really. Permanently unlocks Pandemonium level. Excellent. So I've got that option there if I need it. This is quite interesting. Oh, there's my birth sign, Scorpio. Alright, let's do Aries first. On the sortie screen, you can choose the level to start on. Officers who will definitely appear in the battle. Any other officers will appear at random. Officers who aren't your allies yet will be indicated by a highlighted frame. So if they've got the gold around them, they can be recruited, I guess. Defeat 120 targets within 7 minutes. That's going to be easy. Do that in my sleep. Infinity Mode, you can fight alongside your team members and give orders to the ones you are not controlling. Stay close, fight together with the other player character, move away and explore the map part. Avoid combat to restore health. Oh, that's cool, so it like switches it around a few. That's pretty sweet. Oh, the map's completely like blacked out. We'll have to like explore it, I guess, as we go. Rather just walk into it for me. Chests will appear each time you defeat a certain number of enemies. The number of chests displayed on the screen indicates the number of discovered chests. It changes the sound. Nearly reached our target, by the way. Escape points will appear sometimes on the stage, or somewhere on the stage. You'll need to escape in the time limit to clear the stage. Okay. Ah, see, it's the blue spot here. Okay. Yeah, this is not going to get anything fast. I'm probably going to have to use like Unity to get rid of anything around me. It's the meter resets if you get hit. Well, looks like it. The floors you've already cleared, Jordan, when you meet certain victory conditions, the time limit will no longer count down, allowing you to play without needing to worry about time. However, for cases in the clear condition, it's purifying anchors. A countdown will begin if the anchors are corrupted by darkness. Then you got like the co-op mode. Due to a swift victory, the next floor will be counted as cleared. That's kind of handy then, so it like, yeah, let you skip certain floors. doesn't make things too painful, I guess. Defeat 70 targets within 4 minutes.
よし、任せておけ。
まだまだね。頑張って。まだやってるね。はっ。よし、まだだね。僕が倒したよ。恨み、ディスで晴らしてやろうぞ。
Just gotta find the escape point now. Feels like a bit of a stripped down conquest mode almost, in a way. Instead of taking over territories, you're completing floors on each tower. Chest over here, let's grab it. Obtain materials. Ultimate unique weapons. Oh, Ying Long's been added.
最初の塔は突破したぞ。
よくやったな、お前たち。これで主神の座に一歩近づいたぞ。
父上、わざわざ降りてきたのか。
その通り。わしは最後の塔の頂で待っている。先は長いぞ。くじけぬようにな。
行ってしまいましたね。ですが、焦ってもいいことはありません。一つ一つ攻略していくとしましょう。
Yeah, so like a bit of golden color when it's done.Okay, next one's Officer Chaos.
まだ
戦つ。押して参る。
That's Kojiro.
Makasa toki na. Mite na.
Sekimu o hatasu.
Boku ni makasete.
Kisama no ishi suru chikara o.
Just one officer. Okay, fair enough. For some reason I had the impression that numbers would go up, but I guess not for this one. Officer Nasna. Nice reference. I'm trying to remember now, is that the same doll that he used in the where he had to like record himself at a McDonald's place, and it wasn't, it was obviously like his backyard or something like that. I vaguely remember that at some point. Including the other things that I can't mention because I don't really want to mentally scar myself.
Yeah.
that was fast and easy. Uwu intensifies. Sorry, I just like hearing Zinkai's noises. I like them a bit too much. Ah, man. It's good to see you either way. Gemini. Chaos Origins, which are the glowy enemies that shield other enemies, pretty much. This shouldn't be too hard, to be honest.
任せときな。
Oh, they respawn after a while too, so that's fine. As long as I count towards the kill, then. Don't mind me backtracking. Two Chaos Origins. Hey man, I was just plugging that one anime show to you on Discord. Welcome, by the way. Yeah, we're doing Infinite Mode. I finally decided to get around to it. It's probably just going to be the one stream, really. It's a fairly, I don't want to say easy mode, but it's pretty alright. But it's like, because of how OP I am at this point, I can probably see myself maybe beating the mode in one night. Unless they add extra stuff after you beat the 12 towers. But I'm not too sure. How are you doing anyway? Good, I hope. Oh nice, you're watching the third Chucky film. I saw the Chucky films years ago. I barely remember them though, to be honest. They're then again, really, when it comes to horrors, the only horror stuff I really watch is, sorry, I'm yawning here, bloody hell. The only horror films I really ever watch is anything zombie-related, usually. And I usually prefer, like, the classic zombie films, like George Romero stuff, to be honest. Although I do like some modern stuff as well. It's funny, really, I like zombie films, but yet, like, I've never really watched The Walking Dead. I can't really get into TV shows all that much. Especially with how long some can be. The collect lines from outer space. What about Hansel and Gretel? The one meme that became like a running theme. Oh yeah, you know what the funniest thing is? I was going to do a recorded video today for YouTube. I wanted to do the boss mode on Ocarina of Time. But I had problems with it. The game would crash when I got to Phantom Ganon for some reason. And there was also a case where I shot the video and I realized I was muted the entire time. Which kind of ticked me off, because I was like, great, I've been talking and like my mic hasn't been picking me up at all because I had it muted, which was irritating. So I had two attempts and it failed miserably. Hopefully a third chance of recording works. If I cannot do a further recording of it, I'm just going to say fuck it and probably just stream me doing the boss rush at one point. Yeah, it happened. I don't have any opinion on that, really. So yeah, the gimmick to this mode is to like reveal the map whilst completing the objective, pretty much. For the time being, we're focusing just on the Chaos Origins at the moment. Yeah, I heard X, and that's such a shame. 50 is no age to go. To be honest, it's no age. People say that like 50 is where your life starts to make the most sense in a way. Because in your 50s, you're in your pasture years, essentially, where you know people decide to slow down, but some people don't. Some people just keep doing what they love, even past retirement, which I don't blame them for, to be honest. Doing something so much, you know, why would you walk away from it? You know what I mean? There's quite a few people quite a lot of elderly people in Japan that stay really, really active. Doing, you know, the jobs that I love because it's their passion, you know. It's like when people say, you know, say the term that they're a lifer to their job, they usually mean it because it's the one thing that they enjoy so much.
きな
Oh, really? Well, there you... There's the perfect example. But yeah, some people just love their jobs and love their passions that much, they just don't ever want to step away from them. And, you know, it's commendable, really. It's like the old saying goes, you know, you're as young as you feel, really. Providing you take good care of yourself and stuff like that. It's funny, upon saying that, I've got to start getting myself some cod liver oil capsules soon, because my knees have started clicking quite recently. So I might be showing like a couple of cases of wear and tear. So, you know, gotta take care of that while I can. She's been thinking about it. Usually, when stuff like that goes down, it can shake your faith in things. Just have to let her come to her own decision and see how things pan out for her, really. Some people, if they do step away from something they love doing, they usually find a way to do something similar, but not as copious, if you know what I mean. Like, I'm not saying it's the same, but like, you know. It's like when some people, you know, switch to doing something else in a sense, or they do the same field, but the method of what they're doing is slightly different. I suppose it's like a teacher stepping down from being a teacher and then becoming like a part-time teacher or something like that, for example. Or becoming, becoming a secretary as well is another thing as well. There's like tons of alternatives within a certain field in a way. So it's just KOs again. Using magic earns double. Ooh, okay. Just gotta find the escape point now. Ah, Guoxia. I play as him in Dynasty Warriors 9 because his moveset's kinda different. speaking of 9, I should really go back to it eventually and try and finish it off, really. Problem is, the open world stuff can be so grindy sometimes. Welcome back. I didn't realize you was away. Mind you, you did say he was watching Chucky, so... Defeat 90 targets and make sure I use magic to double my count. Yeah, a lot of these stages feel very samey after a while. I don't know why, but this theme playing sounds like it belongs in GoldenEye or something, to be honest. It gives me like GoldenEye vibes for some reason. I should have a look into the next Warriors game I'm going to end up streaming as well. Although, Samurai Warriors 5 is not too far off around the corner. An Empires game could be fun to stream. Problem is, though, I'd have to play it, like, somewhat historically accurate, I guess. Like, we'd have to play as a character that we could make up, I suppose, that we try and fit historically in. I'll have to, like, make a backstory up or something. Because I do want to stream 8 Empires, to be honest. Even if it's just going through each scenario and playing as a ruler and playing as an officer. I wish Vagabonds would be more fun to play as in 8, but they're only surface level bandits, really. defeat 230 targets and make sure I use magic. Simple. Actually, that reminds me, when does Near Reincarnation come out? Not Reincarnation, Replicants. Reincarnation's the mobile game. April 22nd. Is that next week or the week after now? I believe it is. Yeah, it's not next week, but it'll be the week after.
間違えたな。その浅はかさ、後悔させてやろう。譲れぬものがこの俺にもあるんでね。任せときな。僕に任せて。
Yeah, pretty much. Using Musou attacks, it earns double, so more KO ones.
だまだだね。
早々にお引き取り願う。
Right, on to the next floor. 90 targets. Yeah, this really does feel like a stripped down conquest mode. What about the color pink? It's a vibrant color, that's for sure. Oh, I see. I wasn't too sure where, what that was even from, so... ...230 targets. That's easy peasy. I definitely feel like this mode would be definitely more challenging if you didn't complete the story mode. But I don't think it unlocks until you beat story mode, so... This mode definitely feels pretty arcade in a lot of ways.
この陸白煙がお相手します。任せときな。僕に任せて。
Shouldn't be any more enemies coming now. Annihilation. Defeat all enemies within 12 minutes. Does that include every single thing on the map? Or is that just like officers only? I guess we'll find out. Annihilation is such a vague term, really, for this game.
まだまだだね。
Yeah, I'm assuming it's every officer and their subordinates. Might be the reason why they give you such a generous time, to be fair. Oh, okay, so it is just the officers then. Just every single officer on the map. I don't think their little groups of enemies are limited to that. They have the yellow marker on the target, so... Jeez, all the enemies in the south part of the map. I'm assuming there must be. Yep, looks like it. Yeah, they're pretty good, aren't they? Still love Galaxy though. Galaxy's just so velvety and nice. Or Dove as you call it in the States. Find it so funny that it's called Dove. Yeah, we have a soap over here called Dove. You have the Dove soap as well. That's funny.
まだまだだね。
cool. We can now exit the area. Next room, the next set of stuff. Libra. Beyond my birth sign, next after this, the Scorpio, which is pot destruction, which is interesting. Another total KOs one. This is going to be fairly simple. So yeah, defeat 100 targets, any means necessary. Oh my god, will they just piss off already and stop hitting me? But every time I get close to getting like the meter filled. Happens more often than I'd like to admit.
Thank you.
よし、使命がお前の相手だ。
任せときな。
見てろ。わ、私が相手です。行きますよ。
僕に任せて。
Yeah, increase the time. I'm gonna need it. So I'm struggling to find the exit. Oh, here it is. Never mind. I did find it in the end. 140 targets. Right, pot destruction is going to be interesting. Pot destruction, defense, destroy anchors, purify anchors, and then we're pretty much done. These seem like the gimmicky stages that are coming up now, apart from the total KOs one. Destroy all pots within 4 minutes. defeating enemy officers extends the time limit. So basically defeat an enemy officer if I need the time limit extended a bit longer. I wonder if the pots are actually posted on the map. Yes, they're in yellow color. They're quite sturdy pots, by the way. Out of curiosity, how long do we get on the timer if we defeat an officer? About a minute. Okay, so that's fine. A minute per officer. Destroy all pots within 3 minutes. I'm going to have to defeat some officers in order to extend the time limit, because this map is quite big, if I remember.
僕が一気に決めるよ。僕が倒したよ。
They're pretty close proximity to each other. I swear, I'm unfollowing that bloody Twitter account. It just spams all the fucking time. I'm sick of it. Unfollow. Don't get me wrong, I'm a big Zelda fan, but like, that Twitter account is just too much. Every day, spamming constantly. It's just irritating. Isn't the orders mode for the officers seem a little bit superfluous? Like, I've barely used it, and it's not really changed much of the gameplay up drastically at all. It feels like an afterthought more than anything else. My apologies, Hander. right over there, which is nice and handy. Oh, come off it. I totally escaped. Sagittarius now. Defeats 100 enemies. Yeah, 100 enemies. This is just another generic defeat the targets one. They definitely put these between stages for the towers to pad things out by the looks of it. Plus, you know, 12 zodiac signs anyway. I guess when you have 12 towers, you can't really put any more unique objectives. You have to pad some generic defeat targets objectively strewn about. It's not a bad mode. I'm kind of enjoying it for what it is. It really, really does feel like a stripped down conquest mode. That's not a bad still trying to find the boot. There we go. Sixty targets, that's rather small. gotta find the exit.140 targets, and then head to the escape point.
私と戦いたいの。仕方ないわね。
Alright, next one we're on Pot Destruction again. Then we're on the two anchor ones. This one's Destroyal Pots, much like the Scorpio Sign Tower. I think it's the same deal here. Last pot for this stage, and we just have to find the escape spot.
Thank you.
Yeah, pretty. It's not really a lot to talk about right now. We're just doing like the get the pots destruction quest over with now. Where's the escape point? Oh, it's right up there. No wonder I can't bloody find it. Because I'm going in circles. I just noticed it's only two pots for this stage. I'm wondering what happens when we've cleared all the towers. Is there going to be like a middle tower that opens up in the center, or do we just have the Battle of Zeus in its own stage, as it were? It's interesting that Zeus will give you like these little choice things that you can make to like balance the game out a little bit, I suppose. Probably my worst run for a stage yet. I mean, like, cripes, there's nearly 2 minutes left on the clock. A little bit embarrassing. I don't know if it counts as us completing the stage fast now, though. I'll have to find out. Okay, it did count. That's fine. I missed the day as a Wei Yang was super frightening. Nowadays it looks kind of just generic as all hell, really. looks like I've got to go rounding up. This is a toughie, I'm not gonna lie. I'm guessing the last pot will be over in the top right then. If I had to hazard a guess. Not gonna lie, this stage is a bit of a pain in the ass. Just to navigate and get around. I see the last pot now, it's just revealed. I'll be livid if the bloody exit is like super far away after we destroy the pot. It's like we've come all this way. Okay, that ain't too bad. It is on the other side of the map, but I'll make it. Hopefully. Cutting it quite close here. Have I got to go all the way round up there? To get to it? I think I have. That's problematic. That is very problematic, actually. I don't like this. I really do not like this. Also, I can't really see the map right now. Oh god, there's a minute left. I don't even know if I'm gonna get there in time.
Take him, Ohana. 責務を果たす。
僕に任せて。
Come on, there's enemies there too. Just get rid of all of them. Don't even think about it. That was close. Oh, jeez. That was not a fun stage. That wasn't fun. Because I had to go up and round to even get there. Very easy to mess up on that one. I'll check it out in a moment when I'm done. On the last two towers, which is destroy the anchors and then purify them. Anchors can be destroyed by staying close to them until the gauge fills. Pretty easy. Locating them is probably going to be the hardest part. But we'll soon see. So out of curiosity, anchors marked on the map in yellow. I'm assuming they would be. Nope, they're a red colour and they look like a stick on the map, so. This is pretty much that one battle mode, isn't it? But worked into this tower by the looks of it. I think that's it above. Yeah, it looks like it. This get point's just over yonder, so we're good. Yeah, these ones seem pretty simple. Just run to the anchors, destroy them, get rid of any enemies around them so you don't get prevented, and then just go to the escape. It's better than destroying parts, that's for sure.
やってるね。
haven't seen it yet. I'll look it up after I've gone off stream and give you my reaction to it that way. Like I said, I'm focusing on Infinity Mode right now. Try and destroy it again. Stop sending troops my way. Jeez. Just kill them already. It's only one, luckily, but like, you know. Next stage is going to be like, you can tell that it's going to whip out like five in the next one for the objective. Okay, it's only three of them. I thought it was five for some reason. Might have exaggerated a little bit. So annoying, you get to like the good percentage and then like someone just comes up and like, that's another one down. Well, that's one down. We've got to find the other two now. Seal Bar is so friendly, even when he's fighting people.
に任せて。
In the southern part of all things. I'd rather have increased attack, but we're not really going to need it, because, well, the exit has appeared now. Maybe for when I'm clearing up the enemies if they're near it, but... if they're near the escape point, but I don't see them on the map next to it. Yep, last one is finally here.
この最後の塔だけだ。
皆さん、改めてお礼を言わせてください。あなたたちの力がなければここまでたどり着けませんでした。
礼には及びません。アテナ殿とアレス殿の戦ぶりを近くで拝見できたことは
私にとっていい勉強になりました。
せやね、アテナの姉ちゃんとアレスの兄ちゃんの術グワーってなってバーッと出てかっこええもん。
気を緩めるのはまだ早い。12番目の塔は今まで以上の苦難が予想される。待ち構えるのはあのゼウスだ。油断はできん。
ですがきっと私たちなら大丈夫です。神々の争いを阻止するため、最後まで諦めず頑張りましょう。
ゼウスの建造した12塔、それぞれの塔の内部に広がる戦場はどれも熾烈を極めるものだった。ゼウスの子であるアテナとアレス、二神に協力するリクソン、黒田官兵衛、卑弥呼、ジャンヌ・ダルクらは力を合わせて苦難を乗り越え、ついに塔を11まで攻略する。残る12塔はあと1つ。12番目の塔への挑戦を前にして、英雄たちは覚悟を新たにするのだった。
Tower. Pisces, purify the anchors. Pisces, victory conditions to purify the anchors corrupted by darkness. Just stay close to them. If the enemies remain close to an anchor for a certain amount of time, will be corrupted by darkness again. So in other words, make sure no enemies are near the anchors whatsoever. Nah, it's like a purple mark on the map. I guess if an enemy gets too near it, it can unpurify itself in that sense. So it makes more sense to defeat everything around it. Should have realized. Enough of the stray enemies already, please. It's so irritating. They just like show up out of nowhere and just knock all of your progress from escaping out of the way. I mean, I guess that's half the point, but like, yeah, it can be a bit tedious.
本気で来い。勝てるかもしれないぞ。
See the marker to the very bottom of that, the heart of the map. I can see the tip of it sticking out slightly. Few enemies around. Twenty minutes, 15 seconds. There's probably maybe a good bunch of anchors, maybe. T- two of them. Just gonna scout as much as the area as I possibly can. Time is of the essence here, really. I mean, 20 minutes could go past pretty fast. One down. That one's just over there, that's rather easy. I don't like how easy this stage has been, to be fair. Dotte is here, but I'm not letting him out. Not letting his influence touch anything. Right, we should be able to escape, providing that the anchors stay intact until then. Okay, that should be all of them.
12番目の塔は終わりか。父上はどこに。
ゼウスのおっちゃん、うちらの勢いにビビってケツまくって逃げたんだちゃうか。
何ですか。
Yes, the final tower.
あれを見ろ、外だ。急いで出るぞ。
次々と現れる英雄の幻影を打ち倒し、アテナとアレスらはついに12塔を突破。12番目の塔の頂上にたどり着いた。だがそこにゼウスの姿はなかった。英雄たちは顔を見合わせ、彼の不在をいぶかしむ。すると突如、塔の外から地響きが聞こえてきた。外へ出た英雄たちが目にしたのは、12塔とは別に出現した天の果てまで続く巨大な塔であった。
I had a feeling it wouldn't be over just that easily yet.
何やこの塔、雲に隠れて先っちょが見えへんで。
驚いたか、父上。これはどういうことです。あなたは12番目の塔の頂上で待つと言っていたではないですか。
12番目の塔、わしは最後の塔の。
Of course, Zeus changes the rules briefly, like he always does.
あなたという方は。
だが、この天空神の塔が最後なのは本当だ。この塔を登り、わしの元までたどり着いてみせよう。
いささか驚いた。この塔は今までの塔の何倍もの階層がある。攻略は一筋縄ではいかぬぞ。
ですが、当初の目的を果たすにはここで立ち止まるわけにもいきません。進むしかないでしょうね。
そうですね。引き続き力を貸してくださると嬉しいです。
Now use the sacred treasure, Death Scythe EX, which means I can now use Orochi's sacred weapon, I believe. So here we have the Sky Father Tower, which is quite a big tower, to be fair. In fact, I'm going to quickly check how many towers this, well, how many floors it consists of. Right, this is going to be quite a long tower, apparently. It's going to be 100 floors, from what I'm reading online. Right. Sorry, I was zoning out. What I'm going to do is, for now, I'm going to leave this, I'm going to leave it here for now. I just realize the time is getting a bit late. But when I do stream this again, I will be taking on the Skyfather Tower, which in itself is quite a long one. Won't let me scroll, unfortunately. And you can put restrictions on here, which is interesting. But yeah, this is where things start getting a lot more challenging now, and the mode becomes a bit more tougher, as it were. But yeah, we've done the main 12 towers to unlock this one, so we're going to head back to the main menu, and I'm going to sign off, pretty much. Right here, that's pretty much going to be it for now. It was fun going through the first 12 towers to unlock the Skyfather one. We're going to do that in the next stream, and hopefully get through the end of that tower and onto the next challenge, whatever comes after that. Until then, thank you very much for watching, and I will catch you in the next stream. Ciao for now.